evening. Welcome to Sacred Heart Catholic Church. Today we are celebrating the 18th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please join us in singing our entrance hymn, Table of Plenty.
Only begotten Son, Lord. the whole scene. Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and extend what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Thank you. reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, what will separate us from the love of Christ?
Will anguish, our distress, our persecution, our famine, our nakedness, our peril, our sword?
No, in all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loves us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The Word of the Lord.
Women and children. That means This is a great miracle, and Jesus nourishes more than 15,000 people. This is a miracle. And who are these people? They are those who follow Jesus for many days. And now, when Jesus had finished teaching, and his disciples think that they have a great idea, namely, they approach Jesus and tell him that, "Master, please dismiss or send them away." So let's say, send them to Richmond, right? Send them to Rosenberg. Send them to that Bella or Nickville or Damon so that they can go and buy food for themselves. They want to have a shortcut. However, Jesus has a better idea. Namely, he tells them, "No, they don't need to go anywhere. You are the one who take care of this." And then Jesus has pity on these people. That means Jesus has compassion on these people, those who follow him for many days. And then the disciples, upon hearing that, they obey Jesus. They obey his commands. Namely, they go out and try to figure out what are they going to do. And then here, Jesus wants to teach his disciples, and through them, Jesus aims to teach you and I that we are called to put into practice some kind of virtues, namely the virtue of love. Love one another. The virtue of care. Care for one another. And the virtue of concern. Concern for the need of others. And then the disciples of Jesus come out to have interaction with people. And Jesus wants them to go out to meet these 15,000 people to see how hungry they are, to see how thirsty they are. And Jesus wants them to go out and see how suffering they are and do something. So that means Jesus wants them to interact with people around. And finally, my brothers and sisters, as God, Jesus has a power to multiply the loaves and the fish from stones. As God, he has a power to make bread and fish from nothing. However, he wants to use the gift that the disciples can gather from people, namely 5 loaves and 2 fish. What does that mean? Jesus wants to show us the way that he wants to invite us to work with him, because like I said earlier, Jesus has a power to multiply the bread and fish from nothing, but he uses 5 loaves and 2 fish from others. And another translation says that this possessions belong to a boy who has 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. So that means Jesus wants people to devote something for him. They want people to offer something for him, and from there, he will make it a miracle. So my brothers and sisters in Christ, there are 5 things that miracle can happen. First of all, we have compassion for one another. And secondly, we obey what Jesus has taught us. We obey what the church has taught us. And then we should have some kind of virtue, like the virtue of love, of care, of concern for one another. And then we should go out and have some kind of interaction to one another. And finally, we should offer or devote something to the Lord, and God will use that to make the miracle happen. And that is the theme of the Rosong this year. So as we are the world and we are living in the biblical time, anything you have to face with COVID, right? And please show me the vision for this year. If you read from the horizontal, and then you will see that see for compassion and over obedience, D for virtue, I for interaction, and D for devotion. So that is the way that the church looks at. And if we look from the vertical line, and you will see COVID, and everyone is afraid of this. But if we have faith in Jesus Christ, and then we look this way, and we know that with definite virtues, we can go through this difficult time. And finally, Jesus Christ prevails all. So may God help us to have faith in Him. And this year, the theme of the song is COVID by reading this. But if we read this way, we know that we are called to put into practice all kinds of virtue and have a passion for one another. Later on, Lois and Larry will talk more about the song. But here, I want to show you that we are called to do something, namely we have faith in Jesus Christ, even though the whole world is facing a difficult time. But with faith, we can go through this, and with the grace of God, we can go through. And then today is a special day for our three Holy Communicants, namely Kay, Tamura, and Eva, right? So, in the Gospel today, Jesus multiplies the bread and fish to nourish more than 15,000 people. And on the altar of the Lord, at every Mass, Jesus continues to multiply and He continues to nourish us through His body, His blood, His soul. Therefore, Cain and Tamura and Eva, I ask you to come more often to receive the body of Christ, not only today, the first Holy Communion, but make every weekend it is the first communion, right? Come more often to receive and be nourished by the body and blood of Christ. And by doing so, we can go through all difficult times. And remember, when you receive Jesus Christ the first time today, please, 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 please pray. Alright? Jesus loves to hear your prayer. Alright? Because we are so innocent. And then Jesus loves to hear your prayer. So make sure you pray for your parents. Alright? Your parents, and pray for your families, pray for our nation, and pray for everyone. Pray for me too. Okay? Pray for those who have taught you how to know Jesus. And from now on, parents, they will be no longer going to CCE, right? So parents are the primary advocates and teachers for Cain, for Tamura, and for Eva. So these parents, if you have any questions, please call us, call the information, we will help you. But now, we entrust them into your hands, right? Please take care of them and make sure that you teach them how to be good, avoid evil, and also confession more often. Please come call the office and take them anytime. I am available for this, for confession, for children, okay? So please pray for everyone, and also the fortune will pray for you, and we love you, we care for you. And you are called to pray. Alright? May God bless us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please rise. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only God, the Son of God, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through Him all things were made. For this man of our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified and crucified. He suffered death and buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the Lord glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. With open hearts, let us bring our needs before our merciful Lord.
For the leaders of our church, by following in Christ's footsteps, may they satisfy the needs of all who hunger and thirst for the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For heads of state, may they work together to prompt the famine, persecution, and violence amongst the peoples they govern. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For this faith community, may we cast aside worldly desires for power and wealth in order to renew our relationship of love with the Lord Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who suffer, may they experience comfort and healing through the loving care of others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our beloved dead, may they feast at the heavenly banquet for all eternity. Especially Isidoro Ramirez, father of Berta Wimple. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
This Mass is offered for the intention of Tu Nhan Nguyen. For this and the intention of those who hold in silence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Heavenly Father, your infinite goodness and love is beyond measure. With your grace, help us to reach our heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
us may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift
them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. I will be in our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as the one voice we acclaim. In a similar way, where supper was entered, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Given thanks that you have us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Dinando, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray that, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say your word and my soul is not given.
Thank you.
together we will say the prayer after the communion. So Lord Christ, sanctify me.
Body of Christ, sustain me. Blood of Christ, invigorate me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. But with Jesus, fear me. Within your wounds, hide me. Separate from you, let me never be. From the evil one, protect me. At the hour of my death, call me. And close to you, give me. That with your saints, I may be praised to you forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
When you entered the church today, you probably saw tables and boxes with boxes of raffle tickets as we have done in the past year. In this strange time of uncertainty, the diocese is not allowing normal social gatherings. We have come up with a limited version of the bazaar, which will allow parishioners to participate even though we cannot attend in person. Red envelopes for monetary donations, raffle tickets, and t-shirt orders are available to be picked up in the lobby of the church. This year, we have printed fewer raffle tickets. Each family will receive 10 raffle tickets to sell or buy. The tickets will sell for $10 each, for a total of $100. We will have an early bird drawing for all who turn in their raffle tickets and money by September 15th. Three lucky early birds will each receive $50. Tickets are in alphabetical order. A through F are in the back pew of the sacristy side of the church. G through L are on the last pew on the cryo room side. M through Z on the tables in the lobby. More information about our 2020 bazaar will be presented at our bazaar kickoff later this summer. Adoration of the Blessed Sacrament will be held Monday through Thursday, right after the 8 a.m. Mass. All are welcome to pray with us. Your continued financial support of our parish is most appreciated. You can make your contribution online or drop off at the parish office. There are lock boxes at the front lobby of the church, and the fourth street entrance to the church can be used to drop off contributions, raffle tickets, and paper.
altar floor was changed from carpet to marble, and the cross was extended.
sharp key was removed from the back, put up in the front by the upgrade section. This will allow room for the handicap in the back of the chapel, and also room for funeral viewings since it is such a small chapel. We removed all the old speakers and closed in the top. The altar was painted with the faux paint to match the marble flooring. The statues, Mary and Joseph, which were donated by a parishioner, were refurbished. You now see a sanctuary lamp to keep the light of Jesus always burning. The presider's chair, which Father is sitting on, was custom designed and made by a parishioner. The custom designed communion rail has 14 small columns synchronizing the 14 stages of the cross, 12 arches for the 12 tribes and 12 apostles, and 4 columns for the 4 gospels. There are a ton of other additional improvements, including the roof, electrical, the vinyl that was put in the entrance area, expanding the restroom, cleaning the restrooms, resealing the floorings, you name it. We put new curtains in the confessional. Our budget was $101,000. Our actual cost has been $84,348 with a savings of $16,652. We thank you all for your support to the bazaar in the past. And this project could not have been done without your help. And we hope that this year, even though we have social distancing and restrictions from the diocese, that you will continue to help support the church, because we still have a lot of updates to do within the church itself, especially now after spraying everything. You can see the wood is starting to discolor, air conditioners that need to be replaced, just little bits here and there to make it look more beautiful and sanctifying. Remember in the prior years, over 60% of the income came from the raffle and auctions. Last year, we were able to profit approximately $123,000, which allowed us to renovate. We hope you will consider, if your finances allow, we would appreciate it. Thank you.
The first Holy Communicants, please come forward, Kate, Tamura, and Eve, Eva, a big one. This is a gift from the Reformation. Okay. Wait. Kate, stay here. All right. And Eva. All right, and this is your driver license. All right, Tamura, and then Eva. So turn around, and take a picture with us, okay? I say that driver license because from now on, your parents will take you to church, right? And you are able to receive Holy Communion. So that's what I call driver license, all right? Thank you so much. You can go now. Thank you for coming and continue to pray for our nation and pray for our church. So please rise. And before anything else, let us give a big hand for our musicians and cantors The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son.